What's good, everyone? So my name's Justin. I'm here to make the final day in the life here of a plebe. It's like the last week or two of school now here at West Point before finals week. So this is like the last opportunity that I have to show you guys what a day in the life is of like a plebe, at least right now in 2023 as we close out. So today we're gonna go to four classes. This morning didn't have formation. I didn't have to go to formation, but typically on a Monday morning like today, you'd have to go to an inspection, where they'd inspect your hair and your uniform, your shoes, make sure they're shine, that sort of thing, before you go to class. And then you get breakfast when you get breakfast and get ready for your class. So I have four classes today. We're going from Arabic to math to chemistry, where we have a lab, and then English, which is the last class of the semester for that class. So yeah, it should be exciting. I figured I'd show y'all what it's like to be here, a plebe, at the very end, before we get promoted to Plux and go on to CFT and that whole thing really soon. So let's go. So basically here we form up every day for lunch at like 11:58 exactly, and then that's it.
What's so funny?
There's a fuzzy floating in
there. A what?
This is the mess hall right before the line opens in the evening. Got some A1 people here, and of course, Gavin Matush ready.
So as always, I forget to get the food shots before I eat, but we did have fruit here. The mac and cheese, like you see on Kevin's plate over there, being devoured. And then of course, Mike Cohen here, Gavin,
and then Brandon.
So yeah, this is simply what a dinner is like. You can also get yogurts on the side like that if you want. There's sauces and all types of condiments in here.
So yeah, that's typically dinner. From that, now we're gonna go out and finish out that chem lab that we started today in class, and we'll see where we go from there.
And I will have one question here for Brandon. So tell me, what is the best thing, or what is your favorite part of West Point?
Favorite part? Honestly, I would definitely say, ironically, it hasn't happened per se yet. What I would say would be the summers, just a lot of the opportunities that we're going to have. So before coming in, we had Beast, which is our basic training. It's honestly as bad as what you make of it. You just got to grit through and make it as much fun as you can, despite how like strict he's gonna be.
I have a whole video on that, by the way, linked in the description. Check it out. We have got tips for Beast.
And then this coming summer, we have CFT, cadet field training, where we're gonna be out in like the woods basically for about like four-ish.
Three weeks,
just doing a bunch of field stuff, which I definitely would I miss doing after being in the academic year for so long. And then we got all of our other people, like our boy Johnny Boy back there, going to airborne, other people going to air assault, the IAD opportunities people are going to be going on. There's just so many things we can do in the summer. It takes away a lot of stuff, but it's a lot of benefits that we get from it too. So definitely a big perk.
Hell yeah. Yeah, so like Brandon mentioned there, there's a lot of summer opportunities starting your second summer, which we're going to here at West Point. So for me, I'm going on an IAD or an academic IAD through the Department of Foreign Languages to Morocco. So I had that opportunity to go study now in mid-July all the way to early August, Arabic, and over in Morocco in Marrakesh. So that should be a lot of fun. We're going with like a group of 10 people, mostly plebs, going on to yuck year now. So I'll probably document that and stuff. And again, there's just so many opportunities and places you can go from here. So again, it's just making yourself available to those and seeking out those opportunities when you can. It's always really beneficial.
Austin Heminger here, fellow plebe A1 class 2026. So he is on Sandhurst Gold Team, which essentially, like you guys have probably been following on Instagram and social media, was the Sandhurst Military Skills Competition that happened just this past weekend here at West Point. It's a really great team that you can try out for. And he's on the West Point endorsed team, so on the official team representing all of West Point. So he can probably give some good insight on that. So what can you tell the viewers about like Sandhurst, what it is, and who would you recommend should join?
So Sandhurst is, like you said, it's a military skills competition. A lot of physical events, a lot of physical things going on at the same time. So typically it looks like you'll do a military task and you'll be tasked to do something physical as well with it, whether it be like running, picking something up, like doing push-ups, something like that. Usually something to get your heart going while you do your task. This year we had 8 lanes, so usually there's like 8 to 12 lanes per day, and there's 2 days. The first day is like your medical lanes, your commo, your weapons, assembly, disassembly thing. They usually have a physical fitness lane. And then there's Zodiac boats, which are super fun. And then the last event for the first day is the ruck out to Buckner, which for us it was about 8.5 miles or something like that. So you'll do a ruck run out there. And then the second day is more skills, like shooting M4s, doing the Marne, which is like the obstacle course here at West Point. Shooting pistols, getting to do some more military training as far as like using your map, like call for fire and like terrain identification, things like that. And then you ended off with like a little thing called the Crucible, and it's just like chaos. Like you do basically everything you just did within like 10 minutes and you see how fast you can do it in like a chaotic environment. So it's a good time. As far as like people recommending, I recommend try out. Honestly, anyone, but to make the team, you have to be like a fast rucker. And if you don't know what rucking is, you'll find out this summer in CBT. But typically track athletes, cross country, anyone who can run fast and carry a decent load on their back while doing that is someone who's probably pretty fit for the team. So
yeah, it's just a short video, day in the life here as we end. Again, let me know anything in the comments below. Make sure to subscribe. Best of luck to y'all.